Don't forget about us. Don't forget about us. What's up, Had Hacks? Hello. Oh, there's somebody else that does that too. Teak. He always goes, "What? What's that noise?" It's your own fault though. Leaving it open. Yeah, sometimes Teak always like I'm like typing or something like that and all you can hear is clicking or mouse action and stuff. What's up, Zilton? I look different. I cut my hair. That's probably it. Oh, same thing for you, Silverfang? Dang. What's up, everybody? Sorry to be scaring you. Yeah, there we go. Now she looks hungry. Hungry. See how it looks in the game? Oh, it's going to take a minute to build. All right, the next animation I'm working on is the... I want to do is a melee animation. Wait, what's her hurt look like? She's like, ugh. Many pixels. Oh, here we go. Let's see this in action. Yeah. She's looking good. Cool. All right, that's a nice animation. I like how this turned out. You can see a lot of life in that animation. This one's probably all right. All right, so next one's gonna be melee because she does melee a lot. And this kind of cheesy melee action here is not gonna be what we want. What frame should we start with? What's up, Arcane? What's up, everybody? Happy Sunday. This is kind of a late stream. I don't normally stream this late. I think I'm gonna try her doing a punch. Even though the other guys already do that. This might be kind of cool, or sort of a slap almost. Yeah, maybe a slap. So, what frame should I start with? Maybe this one. Nah, this one's good. Okay, sorry here. All right, how many pixels? We need like 2 pixels on the bottom, 8 pixels here. That's about where she is normally. All right, so I'm gonna start with the keyframes. Here's this is where she starts at. Call this layer idle. Let's get a layer where she's all the way at the height of her. Just full on the full punch. All right, now that this frame is drawn, I'm gonna try. See what this looks like. What's up, Scissor? Welcome, welcome. How's it going today? Happy Sunday. All right, so super rough animation. There's only one frame basically, but I want to see if this even works to have her kind of like attack horizontally. Fast. All right, let's give it a few more frames like that just to emphasize. There's this is the eighth boss, and there's gonna be 9 bosses total. That's the minimum amount of bosses though. I might have a lot of optional bosses actually. So, like, you know, if I have enough time, I want to do a lot of cool, like, optional bosses where they're, like, hidden throughout the world. Maybe one of them's in a cave or something, and you just go in, and there's an awesome boss fight, and you win a cool item, but it's not even associated with the dungeon or whatever. I think this is gonna work. What's up, Kilvarney? Welcome, welcome. What's up, Sound Dongs? Welcome, yo. It is a Sunday stream. It's a late Sunday stream. How's it going, man? What you working on? Chilling. Weekend's been good. Been busy though. Really, really busy. Because we got a Burning Man coming up in next week. So, or not this week, but the week after. So, man, it's been a busy week. And then I had this event that I went to this Thursday for Songbringer. Took my TV and stuff like that and Songbringer and some controllers and stuff. And this event was at the Microsoft Reactor Room here in San Francisco. There was like 80 other video games there, a lot of other developers. I met some cool people once again. This is the second time I've been to this event. So it was pretty cool. It was, yeah, it was a good time. Probably the funniest game, or the games I was like really, really excited about was this game called Don't Get Too Drunk. It was really funny. Yeah, yeah, of course. Every little man gets some nice focus. Oh yeah, she looks like she's got a melee now. Yeah, Burning Man's, it's my favorite event. I've traveled the world before. I took a year-long journey, went all around the world. I found a lot of great places, and if I'm not gonna do a trip where it's about nature, I love Burning Man. But what I'm saying is, I used to love to travel, but now that I've found Burning Man, I don't even care about traveling anymore. I'm like, I don't need to go to another country. I just want to go to Burning Man. Burning Man's that good. It's a great place. Okay, this is gonna work. This is gonna work with this animation here. I just gotta fill in some frames. I'm working on this filling frame here that's not too good yet. This frame is really weak. Yeah, yeah, totally. So the boss fight here, that's kind of the point, is like, first of all, blink is necessary. And you get, so the gate item for this dungeon is the second blink, which gives you the ability to blink over stuff. So your first blink, you can just jump to the side. Your second blink, you can actually jump over a gap. And then the third blink, you can go jump over two gaps. But anyways, this is blink level 2 gate tiles. These don't look very good yet. All the black tiles here, the sky, I've got an idea to make it look a lot better. So this is just a mock-up, kind of. First, I'm working on the actual art for the boss here. There's something where she kills you so fast. I forget. I've never noticed, but somehow she just like 3 hearts, 1 or something. Oh yeah, she does a whole heart of damage or a whole tooth of damage. Yeah, the lightning attack's cool. The one thing about it so far is the art. The art can be a little bit better, but also the sound effects aren't very good. It's just using the existing lightning sound effects, so there's a lot of work left to do to make it way cooler. So far, this is kind of like a mock-up version of this boss. Total rough sketch mock-up. But so far, it's actually been really good to develop bosses and focus on the fun parts first, like making the boss actually fun before you make the boss look good. That's been my MO with the bosses recently, and it's worked so far. Like, first of all, just make them fun, and second of all, make them look good and sound good. Yeah, there's definitely a fair amount of polish left for sure. I'll be probably working on this boss for at least 2 more days, if not 3. But yeah, how's it going with you, man? What you working on now? What part of your engine or school? Replacing the place where we're drawing code. Oh, cool. Nice. Graphics right on. Yeah, it does look like he's dancing, right? You ran into a huge bug with allocator? Oh, I'm glad it was a fairly easy fix. Dang. Isn't it good though to have like the foundations going? Like once you've been through the ringer with like a bad bug with the system, you kind of get it refined. It's almost like, I feel like a bad bug. Well, shit. This is not really like my thought. I guess this is totally comes from Mr. Robot. But you know what I mean? Have you seen Mr. Robot, the show? He talks about bugs at one point in the show, and so his general thought is that a bug is something that you actually intentionally have almost or subconsciously intentionally have put in your code to make you aware of something in your code. I bet it felt great. Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, if you like TV and you like shows about hackers and stuff, Mr. Robot's a good one. It was literally the case. Really? Like you felt like you subconsciously put that bug there to make yourself aware of it? It was an assertion. Oh. Yeah, nice. Oh, I'm glad you found it with an assertion. That's beautiful. That's really nice. Then you'd have to hunt for it. And now the allocator works better, yeah. We ask allocated for chunk of memory. And supposed to chunk based on whether it's bordered. Oh. Yeah, okay. I'm following. I'm following. Assume where the chunk in question was bored on both sides of free chunks, something wouldn't or shouldn't ever happen. Oh, it happens all the time. Oh man. Assumptions, right? Unloading shaders. Oh, right, yeah. Tiny little bits of memory to get left over. Aha. So now instead, the designer chunk is between two free chunks. It just walks backward through the list until it finds an in-use chunk and then merges all the free chunks before splitting off the desired amount of memory. That's almost like a defragmenter. Yeah, hell yeah. That sounds awesome. It's like a running defragmenter almost. Well, I guess it's not really a running defragmenter. It's just a prevent it prevents fragmentation. It's a running anti-fragmenter. The anti-fragmenter. That's cool. Yeah, what'd you do today? Oh, I wrote this anti-fragmenter code. It's pretty awesome. Okay, let's try this out now. One, two. Got a few frames here. Actually, we should at least make a frame where this her cloak falls back down. Let's go duplicate this one. So much fun writing it. Yeah, dude, that's awesome. It sounds like a really fun thing to create from an engineering programming standpoint. That's a really like important, and it's almost like you can get a lot of like efficiency out of that. When you get the efficiency out of it, I can imagine it would be very satisfying. Memory management just sounded like magic, and now it's de and it demystified. Yeah. Yeah, it's a good recommendation. You start with Objective-C? Yeah, I learned it before ARP became a thing too. Oh, totally. Yeah, when to retain, when to release. Got to get a look at this in the game. Yeah, I've never actually even used Objective-C with Arc yet. Trusted it either. I was like, ah, I'm not gonna turn on ARC. I already know how to do retain and release. Why would I want to do ARC? Versus stack versus heap. Oh, okay. This is why you always recommend that. Oh, see, I learned C first, so that was always something I already understood. Yeah, I'm pretty lucky to have learned C. I mean, I guess you could say I learned quick basic before that, but learning C is really instrumental. Oh, right before it went off. This animation is way too slow. Or is it? Wait, it's only 0.04 seconds. Gosh, I wanted to get to that frame pretty fast. Really? I haven't even seen Swift. I've never even looked at any Swift code. I have no idea what it's like. Yeah. And point so pointers are not a thing. Yeah. Unless they open source app kit, UI kit, which they'll probably never do. Just like they did with, it's like almost the same thing with Objective C. People were like looking for, I was even personally looking for ways to compile Objective C on Android for a long time. And then I was like, you know what? It's just too much of a bitch because you gotta like, you also gotta get app kit, UI kit, all those things working with Objective C. Yeah, totally, totally dependent. Yeah, that's the one killer thing about Objective C that stopped me from using it too. I was like, I'm going back to C++. Cocos 2DX, C++, no more Objective C. I can't just be locked into making games only for iPhone, only for Mac, you know, only the Mac world of, that's a limited world. Gotta go cross-platform. Yeah, totally. Yeah, it is. It's so nice. Oh, I just realized these shadows are all the wrong color. That's the right color. I'm gonna do an animation now for her where she looks like she's planting the bomb. Oh, damn it. Thanks, Red Sands. It's a she, though. Gotta have some bosses that are she's, right? Can't have this being a sexist game. All the enemies always male. That would just get boring, right? This is the lightning boss. She's got lots of cool lightning attacks. I'm gonna make an animation called Bomb that she runs when she's planting a bomb, so she looks like she gets down on the ground. Taking you seeing off? See ya? Signing off? Signing off. Well, that's a pretty good start. Got a lot of animations started here for her. So this little bomb animation. Oh, this needs some more frames. Yeah, so that's it for today's stream. I'm gonna sign off. It's a nice lazy Sunday here. Have a nice lazy exit to the